We'll see some property here. Two quadratic equations are there. And these quadratic equations, roots of these quadratic equations are identical, then the coefficients are in proportional. Right? We'll see this one. Here, they have mentioned that for these two quadratic equation, roots are identical, right? We are taking that, let the identical roots are, alpha, beta. We know that sum of the roots is what? Minus x coefficient by x square coefficient, right? What is x coefficient? B1 by A1. And it is same as for the quadratic, second quadratic equation, right? Minus B2 by A2. Why we are writing right like this? Because they give that identical roots for the quadratic equation. Similarly, what will be the product of the two roots? Constant by x square coefficient. What is the constant term here? C1 by x square coefficient is A1 equal to C2 by A2. Right? So that is a sum of the two quadratic equation, and the product of the two quadratic equation is C1 by A1. Right? Now we have to prove that these two are identical roots. Right? Consider A1, B1, comma C1 equal to, writing that A1, B1, comma C1. Now I am taking that A1 comma, what will get? 1 comma B1 by A1 comma C1 by A1, right? Now here observe, minus B1 by A1 value is same as minus B2 by A2, right? From these two, clearly these two will be cancelled. B1 by A1 is same as B2 by A2, those value applying here. A1 into 1 comma B2 by A2 comma. What is the value of C1 by A1? It is a C2 by A2. C2 by A2. Right? Now, A1. Now, take LCM A2. What will get it? A2, B2, C2. So, here we got it. A1 comma B1 comma C1 is A2, B2, C2, right? A1 comma B1 comma C1 can write proportional in place of A1 by A2. I'm putting that proportional. A2, B2, C2, right? So this is a proving part, right? A1, B1, C1 are proportional, right? Hence, A1, B1, C1 are proportional to A2, B2, C, right? And we can say that from this one, a1 x square plus b1 x plus c1 equal to a1 by a2 into a2 x square plus b2 x plus c2, right? When the two quadratic equation have identical roots, we can say that the coefficients of first quadratic equation and the coefficients of second quadratic equation are proportional, right? Now, we know that ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is a quadratic equation, and in this I'm taking that a common. What will get? X square plus b by ax plus c by a, we can write it, right? Now a into x square, we know that what is the sum of the roots alpha plus beta? It is my minus b by a, and the product of the roots is C by, right? So those values applying here. Here we have B by A, so it becomes minus of alpha plus beta into X plus C by A. They give C by A is here what? Alpha beta. Now this one, what? X square minus alpha plus beta into X plus alpha beta is the right. That can be write it as X minus alpha into X minus beta factors. So ax square plus bx plus c, we can write a of x minus alpha into x minus beta. Now, suppose if they give roots are alpha and beta, what will be the quadratic equation? If the roots are alpha and beta, then quadratic equation will be x minus alpha into x minus beta equal to 0. x minus alpha into x minus beta equal to 0. Let's see. Multiplied, we'll get x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta equal to 0. General multiplication. X square minus, we know that the sum of the roots is what? Minus b by a. And the product of the roots is c by a. And here, what is LCM? LCM will be a. So, ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. We will get it the quadratic equation. Suppose if they give that the roots are alpha and beta, if you want to find out the quadratic equation, just write down that x minus alpha into x minus beta equal to 0. So, this is a method of finding quadratic equation if they give the roots. And already previous class we had discussed that if they give the quadratic equation, how to find out the quadratic roots.